Hello and welcome to the TD Club at Tribune-Democrat. I am joined by Roger Bottle. He's the head coach of the Ligonier Valley Rams. Congratulations, another trip into the playoffs.
Thank you, Sean.
You have the Richland Rams. It's a team that can put a lot of points on the board like your team can. What challenges do the Rams present on offense that you'll be trying to stop on Saturday?
Well, they're as far as our season's concerned, they have the most balanced attack that we've seen so far. And they have over 1,000-yard passer. And then over 1,000-yard back. So that's pretty good balance that you have to basically get ready to defend, you know, all aspects of the field, vertical game, and then the inside and outside run game.
This is a big challenge for Ligonier Valley. It's also a big challenge for Richland because the Rams' speed, both of the Rams' speed, you know, could present problems for both defenses, and this could be one of those games that could either be a 7-6 defensive struggle, or teams could just run wild and you can have 90 points on the board by the end.
You know, they have a couple of different kids that are 1,000-yard rushers. They're a senior-laden team. Watching them on film, they're kind of scary because you can't prepare for any one kid. So we need to be disciplined on defense and play good team defense and identify the different formations that they're in and the plays that they like to run out of those formations.
Oh, yeah. This is Rams first. Rams, as you said, two teams that have so many things in common. We've talked over and over again about Ligonier's depth in the backfield. You have that Ryan Torrance's 1,000-yard rusher. You've got Russell Murkowski's dangerous. And they've got the stingy defense, too. Then Richland, they have mixed it up in recent weeks with their backs. John Rizzo hasn't had a 100-yard rushing game in the last three games, I believe. He's still over 1,200. But they've mixed in Matt Schaefer, the sophomore quarterback. They've had a number of other backs running the ball. And Richland's defense has held its own and been in some real battles as of late, so this one looks like a marquee-type game.
Well, I think it's, you know, their mindset. They're very aggressive. They play oftentimes two levels of defense. They're going to man up on you and basically challenge your athletes to beat their athletes.
Yeah, at the beginning of the season, you know, we made it, you know, one of our team goals to get a home playoff game. And we think it's really important to have that home field advantage, especially the first round. And we were able to secure the 3 seed, which enabled us to get that home field for week one.
This will be your first game of the season on a turf field. And with the speed that your team possesses, do you think that might give you just a couple extra steps?
No, I think, in terms of our speed, they have athletes that have the same type of speed. So
yeah, I mean, I think everybody knows that, you know, John Rizzo is a 4-year starter. He's a 1,000-yard rusher for us. Great athlete and great football player. We have, you know, some other kids that have really run the ball well for us. This past week, Tanner Solarchik, you know, eclipsed the 100-yard mark, had 3 touchdowns. Luke Rosich has had some games. He's lightning fast. So he's done some really good things running the football. And Matt Schaefer, out of the quarterback position, has also had some big games running the football.
If you make mistakes, you know, you can get buried very quickly against good football teams, especially like Richland.
And what is it that you hope to do early against the Rams on Saturday?
Well, I think the first thing we have to do is we have to try to establish our running game, not panic. We have to make sure that we can, you know, get them an opportunity where they're going to be able to punt the ball and try to stop and slow down some of their offensive possessions.
I'd like to thank Roger Bynoe, Ligonier Valley head coach. He'll be leading his Rams into battle against the Richland Rams on Saturday. That'll be at Herlinger Field in Richland. Roger, thank you very much.
Thank you, Sean.